The first is referring to that which is here on earth. The first is an indication of the first tabernacle in contrast to the heavenly tabernacle, right? First and second. The first is also an indication of the first covenant given at Sinai with the people of God, right? It's the Mosaic covenant, in contrast or difference to the second covenant or the new covenant or the renewed covenant, if you like that term better. The heavenly covenant, the inner covenant, the outer versus the inner, the one written on stone versus the one written on the heart, things like that. All right, that's first and second also. He also uses first and second to refer to the priesthoods, right? The first being the Levitical priesthood and the line of Aaron that dictates who's a priest here on earth. That's the first system, in difference or contrast to the second heavenly priesthood, which is typified by the man Melchizedek, as well as obviously fulfilled in Messiah himself, who is this heavenly high priest that the writer outlines for us in detail throughout this letter. So first and second, keep in mind, are comparisons and contrasts that the writer is using as a bigger picture to help us understand the importance, differences for us to interact with, of the first system, the earthly system, which is good, and the heavenly system, which is better. The first promises, which are good, and the second promises, which are better. The first circumcision, which would have been the earthly circumcision, the fleshly, which is good, and the heart circumcision, which is second, or the better inner heart circumcision. All right, all of this is utilized by the writer's use of this phrase first and second. But there's another use that he's going to now introduce to us. This is also important. If you recall, the earthly tabernacle, the temple, had two basic sections. There was a bigger first section or outer section, right? The outer tabernacle. And then there was a smaller inner tabernacle or section. Two sections, outer and inner. Now, that's the contrast that he's going to be drawing from in Hebrews chapter 9. And we have to keep that in mind as we're reading down through this passage.